Hey guys, Gus Mitchell here. I had this Chevrolet dealership give me a call. They have a small hive here established in the wheel well of this Chevy Colorado. Now typically I do not do removals, but if you can see that bee yard across the highway, that is mine. So as a courtesy, because there is a chance that these bees could have come from me, I will be removing these for them. So it shouldn't be too difficult. I'm going to jack the truck up, take the wheel off, and take the brood combs, throw the rest away, and give them some combs. And probably find a home for this one with a new beekeeper.
Okay, guys, we'll get these tires off.
So the plan is I'll remove the brood comb since there's a little bit of brood here. I have rubber bands backed on the side. I'll lay these in here, secure them, get going that way.
Maybe I can find a queen.
So guys, we got the first one right here. We will come this way. And another rubber band this way. Now, it's not perfect this way, but it works reasonably well. Now, bear with me, guys. You know I'm not the best cameraman. Get this, these little combs off. Let's see here. take you guys in. This is what we got so far. I think with the size of these combs, I just have to grab another. Rubber bands are just a little too small for this. Hopefully there'll be some in here that'll work, like this one. Looks like these had replaced the queen at some point already from the torn out queen cells. There's some contours under this wheel well that make it a little bit difficult. If I spot this queen, I'm going to cage her up. Almost could have used mediums, but I got what I got. Okay. I assume this queen is probably up under this wheel well loose somewhere running from me. This last comb. We'll put that that way in there. We may come back and cull some of this stuff out later. Right now, we're just mostly worried about having brood to attract them inside. Like I said, guys, I am not a removal person, so bear with me. I'm gonna scrape the residual here. This stuff out of the way. Now, hopefully, by this evening, they will go inside here. I will update you later. Okay guys, we're back. It's 8 o'clock. The bees are pretty much all in there. Kind of dark, but as you can see, they are all tucked away. Couple here and there. But yeah, looks good. So let me get my duct tape. Get my tape. All right. Yeah, sometimes with these jester boxes, the lid will blow up in the back of your truck, especially if the bees haven't been in there very long and have it sealed up. We'll close the entrance. Sit that down. Don't look like we got too many scragglers. Let's take a peek. This might bite me in the bottom, but we'll see here. Not too many. It wasn't a very big colony to start with. So I've posted this colony up to give away on my local beekeeping group. So if there's any young beekeepers or something that want to tackle this little project, see if they can't get these bees ready to winter, they can gladly take them. I do not want them. But like I said earlier, I felt obligated looks like they're gone, and it's a success.